Milder Vance of the ORAM Agency. This is the Festival of Booths, the time of tabernacles, and we are at a place called the Bogan's Oasis. It is over a mighty mountain, down to the other side, about 10 or so switchbacks coming down into this place, and it's remote. We are going to celebrate the Festival of Booths, and we're going to set up our sukkahs, our temporary dwellings. Now, this is important right now, and I will state it. There are many, many, many people that are homeless today because they did not keep the Festival of Booths to dwell outside for 8 days during the festivals, the fall festivals, and they neglected to do that. Therefore, they are now in tents permanently. They have not learned the commandments that were written down by Moshe. So, those commandments state that we are to spend a week in booths. But we're going to go a bit further than that. We are going to look at the systems that I put together. I have spent my life going out on adventures, camping in car camping, not always fun. It's got some problems. So, we're going to set up a sukkah. Let's go do it. Woohoo! Ho ho! That is not an automatic door. So, the important thing for the lady folks is those right back over there. Bathroom is pretty important. If you don't have one of those, sometimes a bush. There are instructions in the Torah about latrines. Refer to them. So, we're going to put up a tent. This is a Coleman Insta-tent. It's a smaller version. It pops up in about 4 minutes. I have used this particular tent probably 7 years. I take real good care of it. And that is going to be the base camp and our kitchen. This is a Wegner Swiss Army tent. It's an 8-hole dome tent. It is excellent in very high winds. All right, Wiley, we're going to show them the different systems that we have here. Now, I do everything as a system. Okay, this is our climate weather bag. It's for inclement weather, very cold. Okay, this right here has my wife's doodads. The bag over there has my doodads. This here is our scripture bag. And this is all the necessary for building fires, lights. We'll get to all this later. We have a Coleman stove, which runs off of propane, and then we've got some miscellaneous. Since this is a casual trip and it's for instruction, we're not traveling light. We are traveling as kings and enjoying ourselves. And if you can understand, let's just take a look here. Woo! Now you can see where we are. And in many of my photographs on Advanced Kingdom, you'll see that critter right up there. We'll get pictures of it later. Here we are. Greetings and welcome to the Feast of Tabernacles with Elder Vance and Mother Vance of YHWHY, the nation of Yahuwah, the priest of praise of the tribe of Yadah, and the royal house of. Well, there goes my wave offering. We're starting to get a little bit of wind. And the only species that we can find here at the river is willows. Now let's look at something seriously. We're going to be looking at a lot of different verses, but what I would like you to realize is there's two people watching this video. There are those that are seeking out and learning about the Feast of Tabernacles, also known as Sukkot, the Festival of Booths, or also the finishing of the fall feasts. Well, that is all required out of the book of Leviticus, chapter 23 and 36 on through probably 45. There are instructions about keeping this festival. And when you don't, well, what it festival is a rehearsal for future events. And the Mashiach, Yahuwah ben Yahusha, the salvation, came, and he was truly born on the Feast of Tabernacles. We can show you and prove you that in the scriptures. Now, to those that are not focusing in on their scriptures, the ones that have the dusty Bibles and their KJVs, and they won't look in them, and if they do, they're not keeping them, because this festival is in all of the scriptures. So, to those, maybe time after, you find yourself living in a tent permanently. You are in a dire situation. You are in a predicament, if you will. And what has happened is because of our rebellious ways, we try to do it our own way and not the ways that is prescribed here. We fail and judgments come. The judgments are coming upon people, and to those that have not focused in and spent time and enjoyed the time of Sukkot in tents, to those that have not, they're losing things. They're getting destroyed. Meanwhile, Yahuwah, Tezavot, Yahuwah of hosts, that king that is promised, the Mashiach, he truly this year has dwelt with us, tabernacled among us. And that's what this is about. It's a rehearsal. And if you do not rehearse, you will be caught unaware. You will not have oils in your lamp. Don't be the foolish virgins. In the book of Leviticus, in chapter 23, if you look at verse 33, write these verses down. Leviticus 23:33. And Yahuwah spoke to Moshe, saying, speak to the children of Yasharal, saying, on the 15th month of the 7th new moon is the festival of tabernacles, Sukkot, or booths, for 7 days to Yahuwah. On the first day, it is a set apart gathering to you. Do no ordinary or servile work. For 7 days, you bring in an offering made by fire to Yahuwah. On the 8th day, there shall be a set apart gathering for you, and you shall bring an offering made by fire to Yahuwah. It is a closing festival. Do no servile work. These are the appointed times of Yahuwah, which you proclaim as Kodesh, set apart gatherings, to bring an offering made by fire to Yahuwah, an ascending offering, and a grain offering, and a slaughtering, and a drink offering, as commanded for every day. Besides the Sabbaths, Yahuwah, and besides your gifts, and besides all your vows, and besides all your voluntary offerings, which you give to Yahuwah. on the 15th day of the 7th new moon, when you gather in the fruit of the land to celebrate the festival of YAHUAH for 7 days. So here it is called the festival of YAHUAH. On the first day is a complete rest, and on the 8th day a rest. And you shall take for yourselves on the first day the first fruits of the good trees, the branches of the palms, of the leafy trees, and the willows, and of the by the streams where we are. It's the only species that we have. And we shall be exceedingly glad before YAHUAH, your YAHUAH, for 7 days. And you shall celebrate it as a festival to YAHUAH for 7 days in the year, a law, a covenant forever in your generations. Celebrate it in the 7th new moon, or the 7th month. Dwell in booths.